After all, we both share the same type.
You had it once. I have it now. There's a big difference. Whatever your motives are.
Motives? That's an ugly implication.
You came back to hurt my husband. First in court and now by moving in. All right, that's your business. Maybe your disease. But my business is to protect my husband. His peace of mind, for one thing. I don't have to tell you what he's been through.
That man murdered my son's, his son's best friend. You don't have to tell anyone, Mrs. Jennings. Oh, I'm terribly sorry. That was your other husband's name, wasn't it? I mean, Mrs. Carrington.
I want you out of our house.
Now, speaking of First Lady, when you think of Queen, you can also think of First Lady. Think First Lady of the country, like Nancy Reagan or Barbara Bush. Think of First Lady of the church. First Lady in the sense of the matriarchal figure, the center of gravity for family, for community, and even for a nation. That is the Queen. The 80s was the era of the Queen. 80s, we had all of these dramas, evening dramas, if you will, Dynasty in Dallas, and they featured these very regal women who were reigning in their castles, but they also were connected to powerful men. So they were queens, but their power came from their alliance and often their marriage to, or former marriage to, a powerful man. That was kind of their center of orbit. But if you look at fashion from the 80s, so influenced by Nancy Reagan, so influenced by Alexis Carrington with the shoulder pads, it was the era of, you know, opulence, of, you know, coiffed hair, of jewels, of, you know, lots of blush and strong makeup and shoulder pads and tailored outfits and peplums and high-heeled shoes, and, you know, the shoes match the purse, match the hat, match the bag. It was that era being very well put together, and it was, you know, the country, you know, was doing very well economically in the 80s, so it was the era of money. So the Queen was really the resonant image of the woman in the 80s. One of the interesting places you can find the Queen today is in reality TV, especially the Housewives franchise.
Now, you can say whatever you want to me. I really don't care, but you shouldn't have addressed my mom.
I said it. I'm not taking it back.
As you never do.
There is always a queen. And if you look at The Real Housewives of Atlanta, it's NeNe Leakes. If you look at The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills, it's Lisa Vanderpump. Real Housewives of Potomac, it's Karen Huger. She is the grande dame, if you will. She's the matriarch. She's sort of the center of gravity. Things kind of silently and very subtly revolve around them. They're kind of the de facto leaders. You know, the queen bees of their social circle. That is that queen energy. Now, the queen is sort of a natural leader. Not only is she the archetypal wife and the archetypal matriarch, so that center of gravity for family, for community, but the queen is a natural social butterfly. She's naturally a leader, and she leads by inspiration. People kind of like her. They want to be around her. They're inspired by her, and sometimes they want to emulate her. Often she's the glue that keeps groups of people together. She is a natural connector. She's often naturally confident, and she's got a knack for having a man. Like, queen women are the women that oftentimes, like, when they're younger, they always have a boyfriend, and when they, you know, are older, they are married, and even if they get divorced, trust me, they'll be married again. I actually know a queen woman who sells Mary Kay. She's very high up in the Mary Kay business, and actually Mary Kay Ash, a queen woman, many female entrepreneurs are. It's the archetypal wife, but that's like the tip of the iceberg. When you really dig deep into the archetype, it's the leader. She's a natural born leader. She's the regent, and a lot of women channel that energy into building profound businesses, and often businesses that involve women. So anyway, this woman that I know, she's a queen woman, high up in the Mary Kay. She was also the first lady of a church, and she and her husband divorced, and honey, she was remarried before he was. So they have a knack for that.
I know when you were little girls, you dreamt of being in my world. Don't forget it, don't forget it. Respect that, bow down, bitches. Sometimes to live my life, but don't think I'm just his little wife.
Queen Bee. Queen Bee is a diva. That's her seduction archetype, Beyonce. So that means she's dominated by lover energy, but she's got very high, high queen energy. And like I said before, her mom is also dominated by that queen energy. And when Tina Knowles parted from Matthew Knowles, it was a pretty ugly split. You know, he committed some infidelities in the public eye. It was pretty humiliating. And once again, I don't know what Matthew Knowles is doing, but Tina Knowles is living her very best life with her new husband. And if you look at Beyonce, as accomplished as this woman is, she is a wife. And she's been a wife for a long time, and she's a mom, and she's got a family. That is something that is very resonant with queen women. And actually, one of their big hurdles is that until they find their partner, because they find fulfillment, so much fulfillment and self-actualization in the role of partner, and they are great companions. They're just great at companionship. Until they find that one, they will feel very, very restless, especially if they haven't figured out and tapped into the higher aspects of their archetypal energy and figured out how to channel that for good use. Joan on Mad Men, a great example of the queen energy, as is Naturi Naughton's character, Tasha St. Patrick on Power. Another aspect of this energy is not only are they excellent companions, but they are the very embodiment of loyalty. Like, these are your ride or die women. These are the women that are, if they're with you, y'all are thick as thieves. They stick by their man, but just not just their man. They stick by their cause. They stick by their purpose. They stick by their family, even if their family isn't kin, even if their family is community or country. These are women that embody the idea of loyalty. They also embody the idea of the finer things in life. A lot of times you can identify queen women just by looking at them. There is an air of elegance. I always notice that queen women tend to have like beautiful jewelry, but there's always something very regal done up about them, especially if they're going someplace. This is a woman that is not going to dress for comfort. She's not going to necessarily dress like a lover to be, you know, enticing, but she's always going to elevate herself with you know, her styling, particularly if she's really embracing her archetype. They have a natural elegance about them, a natural regal demeanor. We tap into the queen energy when we want confidence, when we want to become more extroverted, when we need to make friends and make social allies, and, you know, move with the power of a network behind us. We tap into the queen when we want to bring the finer things and luxury into our lives. We tap into the queen when we're ready to get married, quite frankly. When you're ready to kind of move from the place of having these, you know, fun little liaisons, and some women do arrive at a point in their life where they're like, okay, this is the year. I'm ready. And that like instinct builds up in you. That queen starts when you fully tap into the queen. The queen will get you married. That's her archetype. Like, the lover will make you seductive and beguiling and get you noticed and will get your options and will get you out there, and your love light will literally be on. And then the queen will allow you to focus and find that one and create companionship with that one. That's what that queen energy does. So you can channel this energy in a number of ways. You can channel it into a family for sure, but you can just as easily channel it into building an empire and being the queen of your own empire. And today, many female entrepreneurs, particularly those who run brands that are geared towards women, embody this queen energy and pull upon this queen energy to accomplish their goals.